Okay, this is a quick video to show you how to import and export objects from Dynamics NAV. This process enables you to install changes that may have been made by your partner or may have been made by somebody else in the organization. To do that process, we have to launch the development environment. The development environment is not the same as the RoleTailor client. This process cannot be done from the web client or the SharePoint client or anything else. It's got to be done from the development environment. Once you load that, you want to launch Object Designer, which will bring up this window here. From Object Designer, you're going to choose File, Import, and then you will simply choose the import file that contains the objects you're trying to load. In this case, I'm going to choose this one called 1173 Partial. When it starts the installation, when it starts the import of the objects, depending on the objects and on the version of your current objects, it may prompt you to open the planning, the import worksheet. Sometimes it may prompt you to skip the import worksheet. Never skip the import worksheet. Always open it. Always open the import worksheet prior to this. So we'll say, okay, this brings up the import worksheet. It then shows you the objects that it's getting ready to install, and it shows by type. Here we can see that we've got tables, report, code unit, menu suite, and a lot of pages. For each object I highlight, down at the bottom, it will tell me what my current version is, the existing version, and it tells me what the new version is, including a date and timestamp. This is helpful because I want to check each of these and make absolutely sure that what I am installing is more current, is equal or more up to date than my existing objects. Another good piece of advice here is to always back up your existing objects before you import. So once I go to this import worksheet, I should take note of all of these objects. I can copy and paste that to Excel. Then I should cancel out of this, go back to my object designer, and I should export every one of those objects. You can do that quickly by actually marking. You can mark the individual objects across type. So you can come up here and say edit, toggle mark. And then once you've marked all your objects, you can say view marked only, and you can export that whole group. That makes a backup of your objects before you import them. Once my backup's done, I'm going to go back to import my file. I'm going to go back into the import worksheet, never skip that. Now I'm ready to import them. Now, each object has an action in this action column, and it tells you what it's going to do, and it might replace or merge existing or create or delete. You always want to replace the table objects. So our advice is to click the Replace All button and make sure that all rows show the action as replace. Once that's done, and after I've got a backup of all my objects, then I simply hit OK, and it will go through and begin to import. Now, when tables are involved, you'll get this warning, and I think this is with NAV 2013 and later, previous versions, maybe 9, you will not get this warning. When tables are involved, it's going to tell you that we want to we're going to update that object, that table object, and we're going to validate the data. Keep in mind that importing objects does not change or import data. It's only the structure. It's only the objects that create the business rules and the interface for NAV. It's not the data. So what this is saying is if the structure, if the table structure changed, I'm going to validate the data in those existing tables to be sure it's still good. You have a couple of options here. You can do it now with validation, later or force it. We recommend you do that now with validation. That's going to make sure that the new table structure fits the existing data. Once it imports those, it says, okay, I'm going to proceed and do this validation. Do you want to? We're going to say yes, and it will proceed to validate the data in the tables against my new objects. I'm 100% complete, and my status is operational. I close, and I'm done. I now get a nice summary that shows me what has happened, and my new objects are now installed. If that validation process encounters an error or gives you a warning that you may lose data, you need to think about how to handle that, and you may have to go into tables and clean them yourself before you can import the new table object. An example of this might be if the new table object deletes a field, and you have records in your current table that have data in that field, the validation process will warn you, it will not install, and it will say that if you import this object, we're going to lose data. So NAV is trying to protect you from never losing data. And you would either need to go create a batch processing report and clean the data out of those fields, or you can choose that option to force it, and it will truncate that data. We do not recommend forcing it. We recommend that you clean that data up before you import it. So once those objects are in, we're ready to go. For safety's sake, it's a good idea to stop and restart the application service. You definitely want to be out of the role tailored or your other clients when you do this process. Again, you should only have the development environment open. But once the import is done, you can launch your role tailored client again, and you should see your new changes, the new objects have been installed. That's it. Thanks for watching.